Hey guys, I'm Eleni and I'm Greek and I wanted to make a video about Greek grammar. So, modern Greek grammar. First thing you should know is about articles. Articles are the words we use before nouns and they point out the case, the number, and the gender of our noun. So, this is manousos. So, in Greek we have indefinite and definite articles. So, definite articles are used in order to talk about specific nouns or specific points in time, or generally when talking about specific things. When indefinite articles are used when we want to express some genericness or with uncountable nouns. So, let's talk about definite articles for a while. We in Greek have three grammatical genders: male, female, and neuter. And we have also four, I would say three, but no, we have four cases, grammatical cases. But here we're going to use three of them: nominative, genitive, and accusative. So, what do we want to talk about? Male nouns, we use o, tu, to, or ton. I will explain later exactly why we may use ton instead of to. So let me give you some examples here. O Kostas pezi bala. Here, the subject of our sentence is Kostas. So, Kostas is in nominative, so I must use the male article because Kostas is a boy, is a man. We have to use the definite article in the suitable case, that is nominative. So we use o Kostas pezi bala, which translates to Kostas plays with the ball. Or plays ball. Η μπάλα του Κώστα. Here we translate the ball of Kostas. So Kostas here has something. The ball is his. So we say η μπάλα του Κώστα. We are in genitive. So right here, του. Last but not least, Milao me to Kosta, which translates to I speak with Kostas. Now, Kostas here is the object of our sentence, so we use it with the suitable definite article in accusative. So it is to or ton, better ton here, Kosta. So here we have female nouns. Female definite articles go with it. We have e, this, tin. Let's see some examples here. The same motive. E Eleni pini nero. So this translates to Helen drinks water. Eleni drinks water. Eleni is the subject, so we're going to use e. Η τσάντα της Ελένης. The bag of Eleni. So here, Eleni has a bag. It's her bag. So we're going to use genitive. Whose is the bag? Eleni's. Πήγα σχολείο με την Ελένη. I went to school with Eleni. Now, Eleni here is the object of the sentence. So we're going to use accusative in order to match the definite article with Eleni. So, tin. Neuter nouns now are to, tu, to. As you can see, in genitive and in accusative, there is a great similarity between male and neuter nouns, but you will never use ni here in neuter nouns in accusative. There will always be to in accusative of neuter. So, το πουλί πετάει, which translates to the bird flies. So the bird, το πουλί, is subject. So we have nominative, το. The bag of a child, η τσάντα του παιδιού. So whose is the bag? It's the kid's. So του παιδιού, right here, του. Αγκάλιασα το κορίτσι. I hugged the girl. So the girl is the object of our sentence, so it's an accusative, so it is το. Now I want to clarify some things about the accusative of male definite articles and female definite articles. If the following noun begins with a t, p, k, x, ps, t, d, b, d, g, or a vowel, the male and the female definite articles in accusative have a ni ending. So we would say τον Κώστα, την Ελένη, but we are going to say το φίλο and τη φίλη. So let's talk about male indefinite articles now. We have three cases as before. So it is ένας, ενός, ένα. Let's see some examples here. Ένας άνδρας περπατά. A man walks. So a man is the subject of our sentence. So we're going to use the nominative form of our article. So it is ένας. Το χέρι ενός άνδρα, the hand of a man. Here we answer the question, whose is the hand? So if it's the man's, so we're going to use genitive, ενός. Αγκάλιασα έναν άνδρα. I hugged a man. So man here is the object of our sentence, so we're going to use accusative. So ένα. Female indefinite articles. We have μία, μίας, μία. Let's see some examples here. Μία γυναίκα μιλά, which translates to a woman speaks. So a woman is the subject of our sentence, so it's going to be in nominative, μία. Η τσάντα μίας γυναίκας, the bag of a woman. So whose is the bag? It's the woman's, so genitive. Μίας. Μίλησα σε μία γυναίκα. I spoke to a woman. Now the woman here is the object of our sentence, so we're going to use μία. Accusative. Last but not least, the neuter nouns. We have ένα, ενός, ένα. As you can see, this is very similar to the male indefinite articles, with the exception of nominative, you know, the S is missing in neuter. So, ένα παιδί παίζει. A kid plays. So, ένα παιδί is in nominative, so we're going to use ένα. Η τσάντα ενός παιδιού. The bag of a child or kid. It doesn't really have any difference. So, whose is the bag? It's the kid's bag. So, it's genitive. Ενός. Μίλησα σε ένα παιδί. I spoke to a child. Now, child here is in accusative. It's the object of our sentence. So, I'm going to use ένα. Thank you for watching, and hopefully there are going to be more videos about Greek grammar soon.